Hello Web, I'm Empire's Chris Hewitt and welcome to this very special video countdown of Empire's 10 greatest moments from the films of Sir Steven Spielberg, our former guest editor, our former boss. And this is to coincide with our latest issue of Empire, which is on sale now in all good and evil newsagents and is dedicated to the great man and to his films. And joining me to spiel about all things Berg, he hates when I do that, are two of Empire's finest. First we have Nick Desemlian, a man who, unlike us, has actually starred in a Steven Spielberg-produced film. You may remember him for one frame of Jurassic World as Edmund.
What a frame.
What a frame.
A masterclass. Should be on this list.
It's 11. Number 11. So close. Also joining me, Ian Freer. A man who has forgotten more about Spielberg than most of us will ever know. And a man who could have written the book on Spielberg. And in fact, did. Ian, tell us about it.
I did, yes. It's The Complete Spielberg. And it's available in all bargain bins and charity shops right now. I say it's a complete Spielberg, it's a very incomplete Spielberg. It came out in 2001, and the last film mentioned is Saving Private Ryan, which is 20 years old this year.
Wow. Okay, so get moving.
Yeah, absolutely. Volume 2 coming soon.
I want a second volume, definitely. Let's make it work. Okay, so how this is going to work is, over the next four shows or so, we're going to be counting down our top 10, as voted for by Team Empire, top 10 moments from Steven Spielberg films. And at number 10, narrowly usurping Edmund in Jurassic World, and that bit in the terminal that Ian loves where Tom Hanks has dinner with Catherine Zeta-Jones, is the attack sequence from War of the Worlds. Intriguing. Ian, yes. So why is this on the list?
This happens at an intersection, and what's great about it is it's so surprising. For a start, they come up from the ground as opposed to coming from the air. And science fiction movies never do that.
It's Chubby Rain.
Yeah, exactly.
It's essentially what it is.
Yeah, and it's just so intense. The people don't just get zapped, they get disintegrated into dust. And it's really scary stuff.
Yeah. And Nick, this avoids all the pitfalls of disaster movies and alien invasion movies. You know, this is post Independence Day, and you're expecting these aliens to come and blitz the White House to bits.
Yeah.
Doesn't happen, does it?
It's very much just on an average city street, and it's very much a kind of reaction to 9/11, I think, and the shock and the intensity of that day. And there's moments like the people covered in the dust, people are getting vaporized left, right, and center, and Tom Cruise is running through vaporized people and getting dust all over him, and it's incredibly intense.
This really sort of ground level view of an alien invasion. I just remember the sound design as well.
Yeah, being those honking noises that the tripods make.
Yeah.
But there's also this idea that there's a moment where a video camera drops to the floor and we see the action through the video frame.
Yeah.
And that's a very modern thing. People don't run away from catastrophes, they video them. But also, it's a very Spielberg thing in that, for film students, one of these things is frames within a frame. There are lots of frames within frames. If you think of the rear view mirrors in Duel and the side mirrors in Jurassic Park, that's something that he loves that. Mm. There's a lot of those films.
It would have to be an iPhone these days, and then it would have to land funny angle to catch it.
See, this is why we got this guy in. He knows his Spielberg. All right, that's in. Number 10, War of the Worlds. At number 9... this is a great moment as well. In fact, they're all great moments. That's why they're on the list. This was a tough one. To get 10 moments from Spielberg films was really tough. It was a big argument. There may have been punches exchanged. At number 9 is a great moment from a Jurassic Park film with the word world in the title. But not, sadly, Jurassic World. Not your moment, Nick. It is instead The Lost World, Jurassic Park. And that's the moment where Julianne Moore nearly falls to her death on a cracking glass window.
Is this the greatest moment in cinema featuring a caravan? I think it's... this is an amazing sequence. Again, it's T-Rexes pushing things off cliffs. They seem to like doing that in all the films.
Yeah. It's like a cat with a toy, isn't it? Just pushing it off the edge of the
desk. Messing with people. But it's great. It's a moment that doesn't involve dinosaurs, and it's so memorable. It's the sound of the cracking, and it's a terrific scene.
Yeah, also, it's a literal cliffhanger, isn't it? And I like the idea that it's like as if the Italian Job was directed by a good director. This is what it might turn out like.
Oh, wow.
Essentially, yeah.
You're bringing the big opinions today.
Yeah, it's terrific. There's also there's a kind of double clock on it, isn't there? Because the glass is clacking, but also there's something that will fall and break the glass as well. So there's two time bombs ticking in that.
Which actually saves them in the end, because they end up both grabbing the bag. Yeah. It's a great ending to it. But I think the people probably sold a lot of double glazing off the back of this.
Yeah.
just in case you're a trader who gets pushed off a cliff and you
dinosaurs.
Land on the wing. Yeah, by two dinosaurs who then proceed to eat a member of the cast of the West Wing who's trying to save you. Yeah, that happens all the time.
I mean, you should always remember that Julianne Moore's character is called Sarah Harding, taking a break from Girls Aloud, obviously. So,
I love this moment. I love this moment, even if I have to say it's very, very sad that Richard Schiff gets bitten in twain by a T-Rex. Spoiler alert, by the way. All right, that's in. That's in. That's number nine, Lost World, Jurassic Park. At number eight is a moment from an Indiana Jones film, and it's Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. And while we had a bit of an argument in the office back and forth, and we voted for these moments, I will admit I was a bit of a prime mover behind this moment. This is a moment in the Last Crusade when Indiana Jones and his father, Henry, played by Sean Connery, have been captured by the Germans and are tied together to a chair, and they're trying to escape whilst the room catches on fire around them. And this is, for me, just, I could have chosen any Indy Henry moment from this film. I love this movie. And you know, controversially, it's my favourite Indiana Jones film.
Ridiculous opinion. It's not ridiculous opinion.
There's Last Crusade, then there's Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, obviously. Then it's a long way down to Temple of Doom. And well, then there's something with Raiders.
Yeah. But what's interesting, though, is that, yeah, is that in early drafts of the script, the, Henry Jones was the MacGuffin, so he only really turned up at the end.
Yeah.
I think it was Spielberg and Jeff Bohm, the writer, who said, let's get him early. So he's not the MacGuffin. They learned to kind of find each other in the end. That becomes a real reward. And it's a weird, I mean, a weird film. Imagine that film without that in it.
I can't. And even though, you know, Connery is only 12 years older than Ford, you just absolutely buy them as father and son. They have this great back and forth relationship, this great shifting power dynamic. This is a really, really fun scene. You get a lot of character information about them and their background. You get and you get some great Connery moments. Well, the floor's on fire. Yeah. And the chair. And of course, you get that wonderful moment. This is one of the great Spielberg one-line cameos for me, when they trigger a hidden panel in the wall. They turn around and they find themselves face to face with a bunch of Germans. And a female German officer looks at them, smiles, and then goes, Alan! Which I just...
Which when I was young, I thought there was a character called Alan, which she needed to summon, but apparently it's German or something.
All right. Okay. It's not Alan. Alan!
It's also very, it's very eloquently told, that scene, that there's a crane shot that reveals the extent of the fire that's
been. Yes.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
So good. So good. Yeah. So there you go. You happy with that in number eight?
Should have been Harrison Ford's Scottish accent, but this is a close second.
That's a monstrosity we will not talk about. All right. So that is it for episode one of our countdown of the 10 greatest Steven Spielberg moments. A very, very good ending. Thank you to Nick. Thank you to Ian. And join us for the next episode where we'll be counting down 7, 6, and 5. Thanks for watching. Bye.